Welcome back to my channel, friends. This is Sonia here from Growing Craft, and today I'm going to do decoupage on this box and decorate it into a nice box which I can use for gifting or maybe keeping some of my stuff. So this is the Lindor chocolate which I love eating, and so this box was actually empty, and this is a quite good box. This is not very hard or very sturdy, but this is really good to carry something. Like if I decorate this box, maybe I can use it in my handbag too. I use huge bags. If you have not seen that, I can share the video where I have done what's in my bag video. You will see that how big and huge bags I use. So maybe I can use these this box to keep some of my stuff and safe on my bag. So let's start working. Now to start with, I am first going to prep up my base, and for prepping up my base I am going to use my paintbrush. Now here I have decided to do the makeover only of the lid, so this is how it looks. And first I am going to prep it up with a gesso. Now here I am going to make my work a little easier, so I will be using my flat paintbrush here for spreading my gesso really well. Make sure there are no stickers or any tapes or anything above that before starting your work, and make sure that your box is clean and neat so that once you finish your work, then immediately you can start working on it.
À deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'orfèvre, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'orfèvre, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer.
Okay, so one thing which I realized while using my heat gun is that these boxes, obviously they have this very thin kind of plastic coating. So if you use too much of your heat gun, the plastic is going to come up. So just make sure that you let it dry naturally so that you don't get any of these bubbles which I have got. Let me try and show you. So can you see these bubbles? These are because of the plastics, because usually with the gesso you do not get bubbles at all. So just try to make sure that you let it dry completely naturally, and once it dries out really well, then you can move on to the next step. Now what I need to do is I need to let it dry naturally for some time. I guess a couple of hours is at least what it will need. So once it dries out, then we'll move on to the next step. Okay guys, so my box has dried out completely. This looks really good now, and now I'm going to do my decoupage. But here is a beautiful paper and I'm really confused at how to do it. Like initially I thought that I'm not going to use this happy birthday. Now I'm thinking to use it, so I am really confused now. So I really want you all to help me out. Of course, while doing this I am going to decide and make it in a way, but if you think that the way I have used it was good, then do let me know. If you thought that no, using it the other way around is would have looked better, then do let me know about that. But your views, it always gives me an extra way of knowing that whether I should do it in this particular way or I should have thought about it. So yeah, so I guess I'm not using that portion at all. So I'm tearing off my napkin very nicely and carefully, and once I am done with this, then we'll move on to the next step. Wow, the layers are already coming out so easily that it's super easy. Let me tear off this portion and wow, and as you can see my plies have already come out. So yeah, this has come out. Now I will just remove the excessive paper, but my napkin edges are wet, so I will have to be a little careful. And yeah, done. So here I'm done. Now I'll use my heat gun to run it quickly on my napkin. Okay, now this is done. Now today I will be using my decoupage glue, my DIY decoupage glue, and let me decide how I'm going to put this up. Okay, so I think I'm going to overlay this on the sides also. Let me take out my scissor first. So I'm going to start this from this particular corner. Now with a flat brush, I am going to spread my DIY decoupage glue. If you have missed out my video, then definitely you can check it out and see that how I have made my own decoupage glue. Now very quickly and smoothly I'm going to stick this on the area where I have done my decoupage work already. This is done. Now I'll take it upside and now I will be applying my glue. So I'll just keep on putting up this here so that I know that where exactly I need to stick this. Just be really careful, be a little quick and be really careful when you are sticking this, of course, because we do not want any wrinkles or bubbles out there. Okay, now this is done. Wow, this looks amazing. This looks really good. This looks like a print on my box. And that is what it is supposed to be. So now I'll just cut this extra portion. I'll apply some of my decoupage glue here. And this is just to make sure that it sticks well here. Okay, now this is done. Now it's time to stick it properly. Of course I have done it, but I need to use a flat brush and stick it on the areas wherever I feel that I have some of the bubbles or wrinkles. Let me zoom in so that you can see that how it goes. So I'm just dabbing it on the areas wherever I feel that my paper has not sticked well, and just make sure that you don't overdo this pressing work, otherwise your napkin is just going to come out. So be a little careful, gentle, and you will be very good to go. Okay, now this is done. Hmm. Now I'm going to let this dry and I will be using my heat gun to speed up the drying process. Okay, so my decoupage glue has dried out, my napkin has sticked really well, and now it's time to seal my project. Now for sealing my project, I am going to use my decoupage glue again. Why I'm using this, I'll tell you. Take some of your decoupage glue, add a bit of water, just a tinge of water here. This is just to make sure that your consistency becomes a little more liquidy so that it's easy to spread. And I'm going to spread this on my complete napkin paper. Now before doing this step, you need to make sure that your decoupage napkin has dried out completely, otherwise it is just going to take it out completely and we don't want that. Now why do we need to seal this project is because I am going to use different mediums on this. Like if I directly have to do just seal this one and do some coloring on the sides and the borders, I don't need to seal this up at all. But here I have planned that I am going to use some textures and some colors on this, and I don't want my napkin to lose its original color, its original design, and I don't want it to absorb my medium. So that's the reason I'm sealing it up. So I am going to seal this really, really well. And as a Mod Podge is on now, adhesive which is transparent, like once it dries out, you will not even realize that something was there on the color, on the base. So that's the reason I just love it. Now I let it dry again and then we will be back. Okay, so now this medium has also dried out well, and now it's time to move on to the next step. Now here I have my stencil which I'm going to use on my complete box, and this is my modeling paste. I have a palette knife. I highly recommend to have a good quality palette knife. I'm sharing the link down in the video description box. Do check that, and a good palette knife is going to last long and it is going to make your work much easier. Now with my palette knife, I will let me take this out because I just realized that I should align it to my box and then do it. So now I will be spreading my modeling paste here really well, and I'm just going to make sure that I don't overlap it on my decoupage papers. I love doing this one. I have already done this process on a MDF box. So working on an MDF box and this cardboard box is completely different. Like once you work on it, then you will realize, because MDF boxes are really hard, thick, they don't bend. Now this board, it is bending down if I add too much of pressure there. So you just need to be careful about and think about these steps before you start working on it. And I guess this is the reason I love making videos, so that I can share my experiences and it becomes easy for you to work. Okay, now this looks amazing. This looks beautiful. Let me remove these excessive keys, and now I'm going to do some texture work here, and I just want to make sure that it doesn't go way too odd. Okay, and now here I'll finish it up. So a bit, if it's overlapping, it's absolutely fine, because it's very difficult to find the stencils of your perfect size box. So that's okay, and I think that's the beauty of these stencils and the textures, that they look beautiful. Even if it overlaps a bit on your texture, the stencil, this looks beautiful. This looks amazing. a bit more of my texture paste and this looks really great now. Okay, wow, this looks amazing. This looks really beautiful. Let me just take it up and show you. I'll remove the excess from the sides. And wow, this looks beautiful. Let me add some textures here. This looks great. Now I'll do it on the sides. I'm just trying to be a little careful so that I don't ruin my front modeling work. I have even done a tutorial on DIY texture paste. Do check my channel, and also I'll try to link that video at the end so that it's easy for you to know that how to make your own texture paste. So if you are a beginner, and even if you do have been doing it regularly, I guess trying making your own texture paste is really interesting and fun. So I think everyone should try it out. I have also tried it out and I love it. It's just that I usually buy the big jars of my modeling paste and all, so it's very rare that I run out of my modeling pastes. Plus also I am really blessed to have some really nice craft suppliers who always trust my work. They appreciate my work and send their products for me to try, and I really enjoy that. Now in my previous video, like I said, mentioned that I had done modeling work on this clay, this texture modeling work on the MDF box with the decoupage, but in that I had not covered the sides of that box. I just did it plain. But in this one I was really keen on covering up the sides too. Okay, this looks amazing. It is overlapping, but you can't even make out that it has been overlapped. Only just one thing, that on the edges if you see something pokey coming out, the texture is just smoothen it up so that it's easy. Now on the other side I have already done the texture, so I'll have to be a little careful while doing this. And I'll take some more texture. And now again I'll repeat the same process. This is actually a little tricky part, like doing the sides without ruining your other portions. So just be a little careful, be patient. It will take some time for you to get into the practice, but then this is fun. This is really a fun technique. Now let me finish the complete portions. Then we will be doing the remaining side. Wow, this looks beautiful. I'll just take out the extra pokey portions. And now only my last portion is left. Okay. This looks great. This really looks great to me. Now just a small patch here, and of course I'm not going to cover my napkin completely. Okay, now this is done. I'll take out the extra portions and done. Now I will need really good time to dry it up completely, and then we will be back. Okay, so my box has dried out completely, and now it's time to move on to the next step. Now here I have few of the shades which I have decided that I'm going to use, and maybe I can add some more shades here. So I'll keep on picking the shades. There's no limitation to it. Yeah, you just go crazy when you have varieties of sprays and paints with you. Now always carry a decoupage, sorry, not a decoupage, but a regular tissue with you when you are doing this. So this is one of the leftover peeled off pieces of my decoupage napkin. Yes, if you watch my videos regularly, I've always said that I love, love, love saving these napkins because you can always reuse them and you can reuse them in varieties of ways. And this is how at times I use my peeled off pieces of the decoupage napkins. Now here I have already done my decoupage glue coat on this, but still I am going to be a very careful here when I'm doing this one. So what I'm going to do is I am going to just shake my colors first and just to make sure that all the color and the mediums has mixed up well, and then I'll start my spray work. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start my work with this corner, and then I'm going to just tilt my box this side so that it spreads well. Plus this is my water which I had already used, and I am going to have a good round or a nice flat brush so that I can spread it, my colors and everything. Let me remove the caps. I usually prefer removing the caps before so that you get ample amount of time and very quickly you can just spread your colors. This is going to make it easier. Okay, so it's time to start with my yellow shade, and I am just trying to be a little quick here, and quickly I'll be pouring in my orange shade. And now very quickly with my water brush I'm just going to spread it well. So if you dip your brush in water, it gets some extra liquid, and this is just going to make sure that it will help in blending on the sides. So it looks like a natural color coming up from all the sides. And can you really make out that this spray work was done at the end? No, not at all. At least I can't make it out at all. So now let me add some this green shade. This looks really nice. I love Lindy's face and this looks beautiful. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to spray the shades what I have used on the top. Let me add some yellow here because I just feel that this portion is looking a little dull. Some more yellows here. Yeah, I'll just twist and turn my box, and now I'm going to use these sprays on the edges, and just need to make sure that my sides also get all the colors really well. Oops. Now this is how it looks. The beautiful shades look with the colors. And let me add some green here. Let me add some more. I'm really loving this popping green. So I'm going to add this wherever I can. And simultaneously I'll be using other shades too. Make sure you just tilt and twist and turn your bottle of the base really well. Now very quickly I'll just wipe off the colors from my decoupage napkin. It has not absorbed too much of color, which is really good for me. Now with my now with my paintbrush, I'm just going to spread these colors on the top because I don't want to use too much of colors on my sides. You have to be quick. You really can't rub your paintbrush too much here. Why? Because it is a texture paste. End of the day, it's a paste. So it is going to spread out if you will use too much of water. So just be a little careful with this one. Adding the same orange and some yellow color here, and now with my wet brush I'll just spread it out, and you can see that how beautiful this looks. Now as it's a cardboard box, it's really a bit difficult for me to hold it properly. Now once I'm happy with my sides, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my color sprays a bit on the sides and then mostly on the top. This is just because I want to have some nice shades and colors here and there. Now, wherever you feel that the color has just moved out too much, now let me take up a box, put it here on the top of it, and then I will start using some more shades. This is just to make sure that my shades are looking beautiful. So I'm just going to spray this on the flower so that it gets a little highlighted and done. I think I'm quite happy with this. Now I am going to run my heat gun on it. Okay, so my box has dried out completely and this is looking beautiful. This looks absolutely amazing. I've still kept it on the top of a jar. Why, I'll tell you. But first, I need to add some really nice and interesting elements here. Now, I have these nice shinier stones which goes very well with my color combination. So, I just thought, why not to add these? So, I have my glue drop here and with this, I will be sticking up these stones in the center of my big flowers, and this is just going to make sure that the flowers which is there on my box looks nice and much more shinier and much more beautiful, and it is actually also highlighting my flowers, which is really good, and my napkin is getting some more attention. Done. So yeah, this is done, and let me just show you the close-up of this box. That wow, this looks beautiful. The colors have turned out really, really, really well. Now I am going to use my varnish, and for that I need to do it in an open space or an airy space. So I'm not going to take this to my balcony area, of course. So I'll just open the gate and I won't be able to do the voiceover then. So we will be using this varnish now. So with this, my mix media and decoupage art on an old box is done, and the lid is looking beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. And this way you can turn your any of the old boxes into a beautiful decorative piece, or you can use this for gifting, and I'm sure your friends and your families are going to love it. So I really, really hope that you all enjoyed this tutorial. Of course, I'm listing down the supplies down in the description box. Do check that. Thank you so, so, so much for watching, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.